And up next this week is Night of the Museum, Battle of the Smithsonian. And this has all the same characters coming back and a few new ones. They've got the statues of Custer and Kamun-Ra and...
Abraham Lincoln.
Yep. Not just a regular size one, no. A great the big Lincoln, Abraham
the Lincoln.
Lincoln
Memorial Lincoln.
But this one has Larry Daly, played by Ben Stiller, and he's gone on to be like a Billy Mays type character, hawking things on late night infomercials. And he's obviously done very well for himself, but he's kind of neglected the characters at the museum, and they're kind of... holding a grudge against him, but they're also being shipped away into storage as technology is moving forward. They're getting in new exhibits, and it turns out where they're being shipped, they bring the seal that brings them all to life at night. And you know, it's a fairly kind of standard type of kids movie storyline, but there's a lot of things in this that are way too adult, I think, for a lot of the little kids. There's a lot of fairly adult humor in it.
Well, I mean, it's the sort of thing that they just didn't disguise it as well as other... Because, I mean, a lot of the really successful kids' movies like Up, which we'll get to later, have some mature themes. Not to say racy, but, you know,
yeah,
stuff that adults that aimed at adults.
But these
they're subtler about it, and they're, you know, and this movie is nothing.
No.
Nowhere near subtle.
Subtle is definitely not something you
can... And really, it's just same stuff, a different museum. I mean, now that there's characters fighting, you know, the exhibits fighting amongst themselves, and Hank Azaria, I thought, was pretty funny as Kamun-Ra.
Yeah,
and he also
the lispy.
Yeah, which was actually
Kamun-Ra.
Oh right, yeah, whatever.
Kamun-Ra,
the bad one. And,
yeah,
and yeah, he's doing a kind of a Boris Karloff thing, and. I thought he was pretty funny, and there really were some pretty funny moments. There's a moment with Darth Vader and Oscar the Grouch that was pretty funny, that also featured Hank Azaria. But but for the most part, I mean, this is stuff we've already seen before, and I didn't think Amelia Earhart is one of the main new characters, and I didn't really think that they were a very equitable toward her character, at least the way she's portrayed. She's just kind of like this adventure hound, and
yeah,
you know, she just wants to run around, and she wants to kiss Ben Stiller a lot, and I don't really understand that.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that in this that really didn't make a lot of sense. You know, I don't think it would push it into the bad movie column, but, you know, I think if you liked the first one, there's just twice as much of that in this film, so...
Yeah.
With less story behind it, so...
You know, really this is just sort of an empty sequel.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I mean, if you like the first one, you probably will like this like this one as well. I didn't, so I'm going to say skip it.
And I'm going to say check it out just because it was enough to keep me interested, so...
We'll be right back.